Good morning, dear children. So this is Vishali ma'am, and we are going to start chapter number 21 from your grammar book, that is direct and indirect speech. Children, what do you mean by speech? Speech actually is the communication or expression of thoughts in spoken words. हम जैसे अपनी बातों को एक्सप्रेस करते हैं, जो कम्युनिकेशन करते हैं, जो बातचीत करते हैं, उसे हम क्या कहते हैं? स्पीच कहते हैं. सो चिल्ड्रन, इन दिस वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय स्पीच? स्पीच आपका कम्युनिकेशन. Then when we talk about direct speech, children, it is the message of the speaker conveyed or reported in his own words without change. Okay, जब speaker बात कर रहा है तो उसके जो exact words हैं, that is called the direct speech. You can see in the definition in the book also, when something is spoken directly and exact words of the person is shown, we call it direct speech. Okay, in the books also, when we see that someone is saying something, that is written with the inverted commas. Okay, we put inverted comma over there. You can see the sentences above also. Father said, I need a clean shirt. This is the direct speech. And when it's the same speech, when we talk in indirect speech, children, it is father told that he needed a clean shirt. So what do you mean by indirect speech? Children, indirect speech is the message of the speaker when conveyed in our words. Agar hum kisi ki baat ko apne shabdon mein kisi ko batate hain, that is called the indirect speech. Okay? Like, there you have seen father told that he needed a clean shirt. And he said, I am looking for my car keys. And he told that he was looking for his car keys. So the sentence with the inverted comma is in direct speech and the other one is in indirect speech. Children, after that, there are certain rules also to write in indirect and direct speech. Okay, the first thing that I have already told you, that when we talk about direct speech or when we write the sentence in direct speech, what we have to do? We have to put quotation marks. Okay, when the sentence is in direct speech. When in indirect, then we remove that quotation mark or the inverted commas from the sentence. That also you can see in the examples. Now, how the pronouns will be changed? You can see over there that I will change to he or she, you will change to he and she, we will again change to they. Then change in tenses. Simple present will change to simple past. Simple past will change to past perfect. Present continuous will be changed to past continuous. And perfect continuous will change to, present perfect will change to past perfect. This is changes in tenses in direct speech and in indirect speech. Then children, the change in place will be here, there. If it is here in the direct speech, then there will be written in indirect speech. Now how we change in time? You can see that now will change to then or at that time. Today, that day, on Monday or with whatever day is there that you put. Then yesterday, the day before or the previous day, tomorrow, the next, following day or Sunday, etc. This week, that week, last week, the week before or the previous week, an hour ago, an hour before or earlier, tonight will change to that night. So all that which is on left hand is in direct speech, and the words on the right hand is there used in indirect speech. Children, with this we will do the exercise. So please write the exercises from the PDF which I will be providing you. Okay.